Isn't putting two-factor codes in my password vault less secure? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Got a question related to my recent discussions on two-factor and replacing Authy. And that is simply this. Surely having 2FA in 1Password along with your username password is asking for trouble. If 1Password is compromised, the hacker then has login details and 2FA all set waiting for them. So technically, yes, your security is slightly decreased. Although there's actually an argument that says it's slightly increased. However, we need to discuss exactly why I believe it is still a really good idea to keep your two-factor codes in your password vault. In my case, that's 1Password. The question relies on what I consider to be an extremely improbable occurrence. If 1Password is compromised and or replace 1Password with whatever password vault you're using that happens to also support two-factor codes, because more and more of them do, compromising 1Password just isn't likely enough for this to be an issue. Remember, your data at 1Password is encrypted. They have no way to decrypt it. They don't. Only you, when you know your password, can decrypt the data. They don't save your password. They don't have any kind of recovery mechanism other than the information you have when you set up that account. What that means is, in the, again, extremely unlikely occurrence that 1Password itself were breached, hackers would get nothing useful. They would get an encrypted blob of data that they couldn't do anything with. Now, the other scenario, and I think a lot of people don't think about this one, but it is also, again, extremely unlikely, is that the hackers breach 1Password, but instead of stealing the data, they surreptitiously make modifications to 1Password itself, such that the password manager, in addition to doing whatever it does, sends off your information to an unauthorized party. I am more than happy to believe that random people, random hackers, do not have a way to make random changes to the 1Password code without 1Password actually noticing. So, the data breach is highly unlikely. A malicious change of your password vault code is extremely unlikely. It's all just extremely unlikely. So, what are some possible ways that this could, in theory, still be slightly less secure? Well, consider this scenario. You're using 1Password as both your password vault and your two-factor. Someone walks up to your computer while you're not looking. They will need either your 1Password master password or your Windows Hello PIN, or potentially they would have to have your face or fingerprint, in order to access anything that's stored in your 1Password vault. You can basically set 1Password to automatically lock itself as little as 1 minute after the last time you use it. That tends to be a little inconvenient, I get that. I set mine to something a little bit greater than that. But the bottom line here is, especially if you're in an environment where you're concerned about somebody walking up to your computer, set it to 1 minute. That way, they have no way of accessing your 1Password vault. Both of your passwords and your two-factor tokens are safe. Now, this is where there's a potential for it actually to be more safe. Consider instead if you're using 1Password for your passwords, but you're using Authy for your two-factor codes. Well, somebody walks up to your computer. 1Password is locked the way we've discussed it being locked. However, Authy typically is not. Authy can also be locked down with a PIN and a timeout, but typically Authy's not locked. What that means is if somehow they already know your password and don't need to get into your 1Password, they then have access to your 2-factor. What this means to me is that having them both in 1Password locked by either your master 1Password password or your Windows Hello is slightly more secure than having your 2-factor codes in a separate app that might not be itself quite as secure. Ultimately, hackers have easier approaches. What we've discussed so far requires a fair amount of work on the hackers. You almost have to be targeted. It's easier for hackers to do things like get you to click on a phishing link. Because if you fall for it, right, if you land on a page that looks exactly like the service you would expect to log into, you could be handing over your username, your password, and your 2-factor code right to the hacker, who could then use it to sign in real time and modify your account. Attachments are the other approach. Malware is easy to get on your machine if you're not careful with attachments that come in email. What that means is a hacker could send malware, and if successfully installed, well, then it could do anything, right? Then it could be monitoring your keystrokes, doing whatever the heck it wants to do on your machine, including capturing things like IDs, user IDs, login credentials, and so forth. Those, to me, are significantly higher risks than where you happen to store your 2-factor codes. The fact that you've got 2-factor, great. It means that knowing your password isn't enough. But you still need to be safe. Now, it all really does come back to you. Passwords are decrypted by your password manager and visible only on your machine. What that means is that you need to practice good security. You need to do the things you already probably are doing and know how to do to keep your machine clean of malware, to keep your machine and your online experience secure. One of the pushbacks I often get is that people will ask, okay, if I do this, will I be secure? No, no, there's nothing you can do to be perfectly secure. It doesn't exist. There is risk associated with absolutely everything, including getting up in the morning. What we try to do with all of these security measures is to reduce the risk. Reducing the risk to a point where your account is more effort than it's worth for a hacker to try and compromise so that they then move on to another account. Could your account still be hacked? Yes, like I said, there are some very slim chances and some ways that any form of 2-factor can be hacked, but they are all highly unlikely, and convenience of using 2-factor to me is the gating factor. And I say that because what's important is that you use 2-factor. If having your 2-factor codes in your password vault, as I do, makes it easier for you to use 2-factor authentication, then by all means, it's a great way to use 2-factor authentication. Now, if you feel safer using a separate app, a mobile app, Google Authenticator, Authy, whatever works for you, great. You're using 2-factor. You've made me very happy. But in terms of the difference between that and using your password vault to store those 2-factor codes, I just don't see the difference as being that significant in terms of security. And the difference can be very significant depending on how convenient it really is for you. So bottom line, do what you think works best for you, but above all, use 2-factor authentication. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, please visit askleo.com/168687. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.